Kids, we have already studied in a small detail about your tooth, your layers of the tooth in our live session. So let us study the chapter in detail, your teeth and digestive system of your body. So let us start with the jaws, because without your jaws you cannot imagine your teeth, right? So you have two jaws, your upper jaw and your lower jaw, and your teeth are situated embedded in that jaws. Okay, in a newborn baby, have you ever seen any teeth in a newborn baby? No, they don't have any teeth, so they cannot chew the food, they only drink milk. But as the newborn baby grows up to the age of 6 months, they get their first tooth. Okay, and when they grow up to 3 years, they get a set of 20 teeth at that time, at that age. A set of 20 teeth at the age of 3 years. When the baby grows at the age of 3 years, they get 20 teeth. Okay, that 20 teeth are called as your milk teeth. Milk teeth or temporary teeth, or they are also called as deciduous teeth. Temporary teeth means they are with you for a time being. After that, the temporary teeth are replaced by the permanent teeth. Okay, when an adult person is of 21 years, so they get all 32 complete teeth in the mouth. Okay, 16 in each jaws, 16 in upper jaw, 16 in lower jaw. Okay, when the human being is called an adult human being at the age of 21, the human being get the complete set of 32 teeth in his or her mouth. Okay, this is the structure of your tooth. The upper head of the tooth is called as crown. This part is called as a neck, and this is the root of your tooth. Okay, so this part, neck is the place where the tooth is embedded in your gums. Till the neck, root part till the neck is embedded in your gums. Okay, and this crown part, it is above your gums. Now, your tooth has three main layers called as enamel, dentine and pulp. Now, enamel, it is the outer upper surface or upper part of your tooth. It is white in color. It is hard and white in color, and it helps you to chew and crush your food. Just below the enamel, the next part inside the tooth is a dentine part. It is the yellowish part which is just below the enamel. What is the function of dentine then? It supports the enamel. The function of enamel is to help you to chew and crush your food. And the function of dentine is to support the enamel. Okay? And just below the dentine, inside the dentine, there is a pulp. Pulp is a soft, pulp is a very soft substance inside your tooth, which also consists of blood vessels and nerves inside it. And the hole in the root is connected to the pulp. So what is the function of pulp? It provides nutrition to your tooth. Nutrition means the nutrients required for your tooth to be healthy and good. Okay, and it also, the next function of pulp is it sends the messages to the brain. What kind of messages it sends to the brain? Suppose when you eat something sweet, or when you drink a cold drink, or when you eat an ice cream, you feel a sensation in your teeth, right? So that sensation is nothing but the message that you have eaten something cold or hot. It is sent to the brain with the help of the pulp. Pulp consists of nerves and blood vessels. The nerves inside this pulp send the messages to the brain. Okay, then let us see how many kinds of teeth do you have in your mouth when you grow at the age of 21. Means we are talking about the permanent teeth which you will be having in the future, inshallah. So the teeth are of four types: incisors, canines, premolar and molar. Incisors, the front four teeth in your each jaw, upper jaw and lower jaw, सामने के चार दांत आपके ऊपर ऊपर वाले जॉ और नीचे वाले जॉ में, four teeth from your first upper jaw. You have four kinds of teeth. In that, first is incisors. आपके ऊपर के जॉ और नीचे के जॉ में, अपर जॉ एंड लोअर जॉ में जो फर्स्ट फोर टीथ जो आपको सामने नजर आते हैं, 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4, इफ यू गो एंड लुक एट द मिरर, इनटू द मिरर, यू कैन, यू विल फाइंड इट इजीली. तो ऊपर इन द अपर जॉ फोर टीथ एंड इन द लोअर जॉ फोर टीथ, फ्रंट फोर टीथ आर कॉल्ड एज इनसीजर्स. व्हाट इज द फंक्शन ऑफ द इनसीजर टीथ, इनसीजर्स? एवरी काइंड ऑफ टीथ, ऑल फोर काइंड ऑफ टीथ हैव इट्स डिफरेंट फंक्शंस इन योर माउथ. So, incisors helps you to bite or cut the food. To bite or cut the food. The function of incisors is to bite and cut the food which you eat. So, the next is canines. Just beside the incisors from both sides. इधर से भी incisors के बाद वाला एक एक teeth जो tooth जो है आपका यहाँ पर, that is canine in both the jaws. Okay? One teeth. In both the jaws means just beside the incisors, two in one jaw, two in another jaw. Okay, four teeth, upper four teeth के आजू बाजू एक एक incisor आपका canine रहेगा. नीचे नीचे वाले jaw में incisors के आजू बाजू फिर से एक एक आपका canine रहेगा. In this type, two canines in upper jaw, two canines in lower jaw. Okay, then premolars. And canines, what is the speciality of canines? Canines are very sharp teeth. If you touch and feel your canines, you will find it with a sharp edge. What is the function of canine here? It helps you to tear the food. It helps you to tear the food. As the tigers also have canines, they tear their food, right? So you also have canines in your mouth to tear the food. Then it comes just beside the canines from both the sides. You have four premolar teeth. Four in upper jaw, four in lower jaw. So what is the function of premolar? As they are broad and as they are the broader teeth present in your mouth, they help you to crush and chew your food. It help you to crush the food into small pieces, okay, and chew it properly. Then after that, you have six molar teeth in both the jaws, six in upper jaw, six in lower jaw. This molar teeth help, they are also very broad in structure, they are broad and flat. Premolars are also broad and flat, and molars are also more broader and flat than the premolars. Next to the premolars, we have molar teeth. They are also wide and broad, flat and broad, and six in upper jaw and six in the lower jaw. Six molar teeth in upper jaw, six molar teeth in lower jaw. Okay, this also helps you to crush and grind your food very easily. Okay, the third pair of your molar tooth, the third pair of your molar teeth is also called as wisdom teeth. Have you ever heard your parents telling akal darai? Yes, that is nothing but the wisdom teeth. The third pair of your molar teeth present in your mouth is called as wisdom teeth. Okay, now why teeth are important? You came to know that it helps us to chew our food properly, because when we chew our food properly, it get digested properly. It is very necessary to chew the food properly to get digested properly. Okay, so for this purpose, we need to take care of our teeth. It is very important for us to take care of our teeth. what happens when we eat food, minute or tiny food particles, they get stuck between our teeth, right? And it forms a yellow layer on our teeth called as plaque. It is called as plaque. The yellow layer formed over above our teeth, that layer is called as plaque. It is formed by the tiny food particles which get stuck between our teeth. And this results in the form, and it is very sticky layers, and it consists of germs in it. It consists of germs in it, and these germs, they slowly release some acids in your teeth, and they eat your tooth enamel and forms a cavity inside your teeth. And after some time, if there is cavity in your tooth, you feel pain when you eat or drink something. Okay, so that's why it is very important for us to take care of our tooth or teeth properly. Okay, now let us discuss some tips how to maintain the health of our teeth. Okay, so for this, you need to brush your teeth twice a day. Once when you get up in the morning, and second time when you in the night when before going to the bed. Okay, begin the brushing of your teeth by making gentle strokes. You should not use a hard bristle toothbrush for brushing your teeth. You should use soft bristle toothbrush for brushing your teeth, and you should give gentle strokes, not hard strokes. It may cause your harm to your gums. Okay, so you should make gentle strokes while brushing your teeth, and the front teeth must be brushed in which movement? Up and down, and the other teeth should be given the circular movement for brushing purpose. Okay, this will ensure that the food does not remain stuck between the teeth. Okay, eat healthy food. Milk products and milk makes your teeth more stronger, so you should use milk and milk product in your daily diet. Avoid eating too many sweet and chocolates. You should avoid eating chocolates and sweets, because eating too much sweets and chocolates tends to create more cavities in your teeth. Remember to rinse your mouth after eating. जैसे खाना खाने के बाद आपने क्या करना है, आपके मुंह को अच्छे से साफ करना है, कुल्ली करना है जाके. So that will clean your teeth. आपके जो दांत के बीच में जो tiny particles stuck हो जाते हैं, it will remove it out of your mouth. Okay? Then fluoride also remove the layer which is formed over your teeth. So the toothpaste containing fluoride should be used for the brushing purpose. Okay, you should use dental floss after eating. What is the dental floss? It is a special kind of thread which helps you to remove the tiny particle which are stuck between your teeth. Okay, so it is called as dental floss, FLOSS, floss. It is a special kind of thread used for cleaning the teeth. Then you should visit your dentist at least 2 times in a year. You should visit your dentist at least twice in a year. So these are few tips which if you follow these steps, you can maintain your teeth in a good manner. You can keep your teeth healthy. Okay, so let us proceed. After chewing the food, what process begin when you swallow your food? It enters the food pipe, right? Through the food pipe, it enters your stomach, then in the large intestine, then small intestine. Okay, so let us discuss about the digestion of our food. How the digestive system works. So let us understand the word digestion. What is digestion? While eating, do we chew the food or we swallow it as it is? No. we chew the food properly and then we swallow it. So the food we eat is used by our body for getting nutrients. So it has to be first broken down into simpler substances that can be easily absorbed by the body. So this process of breaking down the food into simpler substances is known as digestion. Okay, now how does the digestion process starts? It starts from our mouth. We keep the food inside our mouth. Our teeth helps us to chew the food properly. Then it is passed into our food pipe. So while chewing the food, we have salivary glands present in our mouth. So what does the salivary glands do? It secretes the substances, liquid called as saliva, which moisten your food and make it soft to digest properly. So after mouth, the food is sent to the stomach using your food pipe. Okay, using your food pipe. So the food pipe, the stomach is nothing but the bag of muscles. Stomach is a bag of muscles. When food enters the stomach, stomach also releases some juices which is helpful for digestion of your food. Okay, and what happens in stomach when the juice is released in the stomach, when different juices are released in the stomach, what happens? The proteins present in the food, it also get breaks into simpler forms. Okay, then after stomach, the food enters in a tube, coiled tube like structure called as small intestine. It enters in the tube, a coiled tube like structure called as small intestine. What happens in small intestine? When food enters in small intestine, your liver and your pancreas also release some digestive juices which helps the breakdown of food into the intestine. Okay, now after mixing with the juices of liver and pancreas, now almost your food is in the liquid form in your small intestine. Okay, and it is absorbed into the blood through the walls of small intestine. The absorbed food is taken by the blood to all the parts of the body. The process of digestion now completes here. Okay, then what happens? The undigested food is sent or transferred to the large intestine. What happens in large intestine? The unabsorbed water is absorbed in the large intestine and it is sent to the kidneys, and finally through urinary tract, the unwanted water or acids comes out, or it is given out of the body. Okay, and the remaining solid undigested food is excreted through your anus. That is your excretory organ. Okay, so it is excreted through the from the body through the anus. And what is what are the constituents of your digestive system? Your mouth, stomach, liver, pancreas and intestine makes your digestive system. What makes your digestive system? Mouth, stomach, liver, pancreas and intestine. It all together makes your digestive system. Now, to maintain your health properly, you should maintain your digestive system in a good health, in a good way. So, for this, let us discuss some healthy habits of eating. Make sure that our digestive system keeps working properly and for that purpose we must wash our hands before and after eating. Okay, before and after eating our meals. Now you should fix a time for eating. Suppose if you eat 8 o'clock in the morning, then 1 o'clock in afternoon, and 7 or 8 o'clock in the evening. So you should follow the same routine and timetable every day. You should not change eating habits. For maintaining your digestive system good, you should maintain your, you should fix your time of meals. Okay, and you should eat slowly and chew the food properly. You should have patience while eating. You should not be in hurry. You should not swallow the food as it is. Chew it properly so the food which you are eating gets absorbed properly and it is used by your body. Okay? Then we must avoid overeating. Jaisa, when you get something good and tasty, what happens? You want to eat more and more. Like your pizzas, your burger and noodles. You eat these things again and again, and sometimes overeating is also done by you. So this should not happen. It harms and it affects your digestive system. Okay? And after that, you should avoid drinking water between and in the mid of your meal, during your meal. Immediately after meal, you should not drink water. You should drink water and half an hour before or half an hour after your meal. Just after meal, you should not drink water. Okay? Avoid exercising or playing immediately after eating. Immediately after eating, you should not do exercises. You should not go for a walk. You should not sleep immediately after eating. This can affect your digestive system. And you should make sure that the food you are eating should be rich in all nutrients. And it should be a balanced diet. You should avoid junk food in your meals. Okay, so these are few healthy eating habits which you should follow for maintaining the good health of your digestive system. Now, let us study about the microbes. What are microbes? Microbes are microorganisms. The name itself, what it suggests, they are very micro, which are not visible by your naked eyes. You have to use microscopes for the visibility of these microbes. Okay, so microbes are the tiny organisms called as bacteria. There are many such tiny organisms present around us. These tiny organisms are called as microbes. Okay? They grow rapidly in warm and moist weather along with the presence of food and air. They grow at the moist places in the presence of air. Okay? And microbes, they cause diseases. Microbes are nothing but the germs which causes diseases in your body. Okay, let us study about the kinds of microbes, types of microbes present. So there are 5 types of microbes present: bacteria, viruses, fungi, protozoa and algae. Okay, what are bacteria then? They are single-celled organisms. They are found everywhere. Diseases such as tuberculosis, typhoid and pneumonia are caused by bacteria. Okay? Which diseases are caused by bacteria? Tuberculosis, typhoid and pneumonia. Okay? Then it comes to, let us study about viruses. nowadays one virus is the most popular virus, trending virus called as COVID-19. It is also a type of virus. Viruses are bacteria may be good and may be bad. Some viruses are good for the human body and some viruses are not good for the human body. So the viruses are smaller than bacteria, and diseases such as chickenpox, dengue, polio, flu and common cold are caused by different types of viruses. Okay, then fungi. They grow on decaying matter. Some fungi can help make the bread, making the bread soft, such as yeast. You bring breads to your homes, right? So that breads they are made using the fungi called as yeast. Okay, fungi can also cause skin diseases such as ringworm. Okay, now protozoa. Protozoa are single-celled organism. It is made up of only one cell. There are many cells present in your body, right? But imagine protozoa is a only single-celled organism. Only one cell. It is only one cell. So they cause diseases such as malaria and dysentery. Dysentery means loose motions, okay, and malaria. Algae, what are algae? They are aquatic organisms that have the ability to conduct photosynthesis. So algae helps to in the formation of in the process of photosynthesis. Okay, now let us see how the microbes are useful. Okay, some kinds of bacteria and fungi can be useful to us. The useful bacteria changes your milk to curd. They help in digestion of roughage in animals. They produce vitamin in our body. They help in decay of dead plants and animals. Okay, and fungi, how they help us? They are used in medicine and they are used in making breads and biscuits. So kids, I hope you understand the lesson. If you have any difficulty in understanding this lesson, I suggest you to note down the difficult points on a paper, and we will discuss these points inshallah in the live session, next live session. Okay, I am going to assign you homework on this, and you should complete the homework on time. Jazakallah khair. Allah Hafiz.